It's actually the RFID chip. RFID stands for Radiant Force Field Identification. We are in the spiritual age, okay? So you are an electrical being. The spirit is electricity, all right? The soul is magnetism. They understand that the Kundalini energy is rising not only on the planet, but within each and every vessel, especially the gods, the Atlantean gods, your aboriginal beings, the indigenous ones, your black and Latino individuals around, all around the land. Okay? They understand this. So they need to eliminate the target. You are the target, but they cannot eliminate you unless they identify you. Okay? They used to use nanobots. They've been using nanobots since the 1900s, but we are rising and our spiritual development is at such a level that the nanobots are melting because we are heating up within. The Kundalini energy rises, the warmer it gets, the warmer we get, the stronger we get. All right? So you have to understand that you have seven chakras. They go along the base of your spine, right? Each chakras, each one is a door. You're supposed to open the door, all right? So imagine you trying to get in your house, but you got all this debris and shit in front of your door. You can't get in your house, right? You got to clean the debris up so you can open the door and walk in your house. Well, it's the same thing with your chakras. You have to open each chakra so that you can let the cosmic vibratory energy into the chakra and the spiritual energy into the chakra. And you have to, and you can escape also through these chakras. So you have
a lot of people.
A lot of people don't know the truth about the chakras, right? So they say things like, oh, well, get out of your root chakra, but they really mean get out of your lower self, all right? So you got to understand that they want to identify your force field. They want to identify your force field, okay, so that they can detonate you. These chips will detonate. These chips will also be used to...
There's a lot of our people, man, at that North Pole that's never left the presence of the Black Sun. This gamma radiation energy that they've been absorbing for generations to generation. Some of our people are so big, 25 feet tall, strong as hell, super saiyans. Can't nothing stop them. And this is why the U.S. is really scared, because a lot of us share the same genetics with these beings from the inner earth, the Elohim. And so when that black sun rises, it basically just gives back that power that we once used to have. And of course, from there on, millions of Super Saiyans on the surface.
What made the dinosaurs go extinct? Do you realize they're asking the wrong question? The question is not what made them go extinct. The question is, did they go extinct? Now, they didn't call them dinosaur, though. They called them dragon. See, the word dinosaur wasn't made up till 1841. So for most of human history, these creatures are called dragons. Did you know dinosaurs not even in the dictionary in 1891? For most of human history, they were known as dragons. Now, dragons are mentioned in the Bible 34 times. People say, why aren't dinosaurs in the Bible? Last night, I'm talking to this lady at the counter at the hotel. She said, well, dinosaurs aren't in the Bible. I said, that's correct. That word wasn't made up till 1841. And if you got the right Bible, that was translated 1611. So of course you're not going to find that word in there. Duh. But they called them dragons. Dragons are listed in the dictionary in 1946 as now rare. As the population of people began to grow after the flood, the population of dragons began to go down. Because nobody wants to live next door to a dragon. Same thing happened in Cobb County, Georgia, where Atlanta is today. Do you realize how many grizzly bears there are roaming around the woods right now near Atlanta, Georgia? Zero. You know how many there were just 300 years ago? Hundreds. What happened to the grizzly bears in Cobb County, Georgia? Well, as people move in and civilize an area, the big ferocious animals are killed off or driven off. Happens everywhere. If it came on the evening news tonight that there were 5 grizzly bears roaming around Cobb County, you know what would happen by 6 o'clock in the morning? They'd all be dead. Because every redneck in 4 states would be out there with a rifle trying to shoot one. Right? And whoever could shoot the biggest one would be a hero. They'd have his picture on the front page. Hey, Bubba shot the grizzly bear and saved the village. Yeah, he did. Well, that's exactly what happened to the dragons. Man, if you could figure out a way to kill a dragon, they'd be telling stories about you around the campfire from now on. People kill dragons for meat because they were a menace, to prove you're a hero, to prove you're superior, competition for land, or for medicinal purposes. Many ancient recipes call for dragon blood, dragon bones, dragon saliva. Why? Gilgamesh is famous for slaying a dragon. A Chinese legend tells about a guy named Yu that surveyed the land of China. It says, after the flood, he surveyed the land and divided it into sections. He built channels to drain the water off to the sea and make the land livable again. Many snakes and dragons were driven from the marshlands. Yeah, that's just normal. If you want to build a city, you got to, you know, drive off the dragons and then build your city. I mean, it was expected. You got to drive the dragons off. Okay? Why would the Chinese calendar have 11 real animals, you know, the pig, the duck, the dog, and a dragon? Why would they put a mythical animal in there? Could it be that at the time they came up with these 12 symbols, there were 12 real animals? Here's one of the oldest pieces of pottery on planet Earth. It's a piece of slate from Egypt, first dynasty of United Egypt. It shows long-necked dragons. We make replicas of it if you want to get one for a prize for your bus route, for some to give out to the kid who does whatever, you know. They'll go crazy over this thing. Half-size replicas of the oldest piece of pottery on Earth. Why would they put long-necked dinosaurs on pottery 3,800 years ago? Here's two long-necked dinosaurs with a sheep in between their mouths. Here's a hippo tusk from the 12th century BC showing an animal with a long neck and a long tail. There's a cylinder seal showing what appears to quite obviously be long-necked dinosaurs. The Bible talks about a fiery flying serpent in Isaiah 14. Wait a minute, fiery flying serpent? Well, if you read the story of Herodotus, Herodotus says he went to a certain place in Arabia, almost exactly opposite Buto, to make inquiries concerning the winged serpents. On my arrival, I saw the backbones and ribs of serpents in such numbers as it's impossible to describe. The winged serpent is shaped like the water snake. Its wings are not feathered, but resemble very closely those of the bat. The people where the bones lie at the entrance of a narrow gorge between steep mountains. The story goes that with the spring, the winged snakes come flying from Arabia towards Egypt, but are met in this gorge by the bird called ibises.
Yo, I don't care what nobody say. Doing that September the 1st, not going to work, not doing this or that, ain't gonna do nothing, bruh. Like, did y'all forget they literally shut down the whole world and put everyone out of work on purpose just to test us, to see if we would come together? And guess what happened? We didn't. The main issue that people need to do, not on September the 1st, right now, is start using their brain. We have to change the mindset of everyone. That's the only way we gonna ever see change. Because at the end of the day, the people that sharing this message so hard is not even going to do it. They don't even know we're in the middle of a war. The boys could come knocking on their door and try to force hot sauce them, and they don't even understand the true nature of what they're doing. They don't know we're in a battle for our souls and spirits. So how can we rely on anyone that don't know this? They don't even know death is an illusion. They don't know that we're facing eternity. They don't even know it's mind over matter.
If this God was jealous of other gods, and this God had to use dirt and clay in order to make his children, how jealous of you do you think he is of the goddess who can just give birth? I mean, this would be the same God that said y'all dirty because of y'all periods, but that's life, nigga. They said y'all dirty after y'all give birth, that y'all so dirty that y'all can't fucking teach or preach in the goddamn church, but yet you godly enough to give birth to God. I mean, if you could have made Adam out of dirt, why the hell didn't you do Jesus? Why'd you have him come from a dirty womb? Or maybe this nigga don't really have the ability to create like people been saying he does. And there's a reason he jealous, because he can't do what the goddesses do. And there's a reason he mistreats women and has them give up their firstborn child, because you ain't got shit to do with that, nigga. And niggas put their seed in women all the time and leave, so it's not that hard. If we're made in the image of God, then it should hurt us to leave our firstborn child, right? Our only begotten son. No, we leave them little niggas and nigglets all the time. But for a woman to do that, after raising it for 9 months, after giving it all your stem cells, the child is basically the woman. Unless the Y chromosome mutates it into a boy, it's a clone of the woman. Everything we get is of our mother. That's what they don't want to tell y'all. That's the big fucking secret. The big secret is all this darkness is the Dark Mother, the Great Mother, and we sit in her cosmic womb. That's the secret. Why is there so much women hate, especially for my woman? Why? What the fuck did she do? Why do men love pussy but hate women? Start asking yourself these questions. How come in the Bible and the Quran it says that we have to return to the bosom of God or Allah, but the word bosom is only used for women? How could God give birth if he ain't got a portal? You didn't birth the universe, you didn't birth nothing. This God y'all think y'all love and cherish can only manipulate matter, but Mama, she is matter. She is the creation of matter. Some weak-ass inferiority complex these niggas got. But there's a difference between us and them. The mother's sons, the May sons, and them niggas. So I don't give a shit about Mother Earth, the mothers, the children. They never did. Sacrificing their children is something they do apparently seamlessly. They just go ahead and do it. That don't make no damn sense to me, God. Why the fuck would you have me sacrifice my only child? More my child, nigga, even if it's more, I'm more than nigga, no. Shit going on here on this planet is a lot deeper.
People be mad at you for telling the truth. This is Harvard in 1867, but I don't believe that's the correct information. And you trying to tell me? John Harvard was the founder. Then it was established in 1636. Let's say somebody lying, right? So tell me this. When was this photo taken? Where are the rest of the photos at? I believe this is the actual photo that was taken in the 1600s of what they saw. That's a question you should ask yourself. So I took a look at Google info. It's all bullshit. Then they label it as an enslavement story. The math ain't matching. So where are the construction photos? Besides a comic book image, where are the slaves at? They don't look like any to me. This means history writers are lying. American history is the worst story ever. We know they manipulated our people with fake religious practices to cheat them out of their position. But little do y'all know, this is a Tartarian castle. Our people kept the maintenance up, which is going to lead further back to the timeline of our people living in castles. I'm trying to tell you. That's the missing piece from our timeline. They take credit when it doesn't belong to them. Whoever controls the media controls the mind.
If you have some kind of contract to repay a debt, it may be written in dollars or pounds or euros. But if these psychopaths go to a digital currency, you have no agreement to pay in a digital currency. The currency that you took a so-called loan in had a paper equivalent. So if they want you to pay in a digital-only currency, that is retrospectively changing the contract, which they cannot do. For instance, they cannot require you to pay off a dollar loan with a Fed coin. It's not the same thing. Now, chances are the original contract for debt was unlawful anyway, and you already don't owe it. But in any case, seems to me the faster they go to a digital currency, the faster they discharge your debt. And what about national debt? We keep hearing about it, how many trillions nations owe and how they're paying more in interest than their entire GDPs. But who is that debt owed to? Banks. Do we care if the banks get paid? And who's going to enforce it if they aren't? US military? Trillions of dollars have disappeared into the Pentagon that can't be accounted for, which means the military are getting kickbacks from weapons suppliers, which means the suppliers aren't meeting proper standards, which means the US military has a whole lot of shit that doesn't work. Besides, if it's politicians and bureaucrats who ran up the debt, let them be the ones to repay it, not the people. They've been running a very badly mismanaged corporation. All these governments are corporations. It's corporate debt, it's not the people's debt. They want to put it on our backs for generations. But if we're talking render unto Caesar what is Caesar's, then it is Caesar's debt, because it is a debt-based currency. Ultimately, I'm just thinking out loud here, but prophetically, I understand this better. For the outcome of these times is that the corporate pharaohs, just like the pharaoh of Moses' time, are racing to their destruction. And with their destruction in Moses' time, with his destruction in Moses' time, came the end of slavery. And we have many forms of slavery today: wage slavery, tax slavery, prison slavery, sex slavery, death cult slavery, and debt slavery. And this shall all be destroyed. So be it.
I don't even know how I get picked to do all this. I don't even know how this happened. How y'all choose me? Oh, out of everybody to do all of this. God, man, I gotta live down here. Y'all don't. Want me to fight their battles and do all this? Change anything, do that. No, you gotta be the chosen one and stuff. Man. When I get to the other side, I want my homage paid for real. Man, where they at? Let's go.
Don't tell him what I'm about to say and see if he knows about it.
Okay.
So what we do is we play with our own forces, make sure our trickery will work on the enemy. And those are directed energy weapons, of where we do intersecting beams or focus beams into the atmosphere. And notice they're always in the atmosphere to excite the electron orbitals of the oxygen and nitrogen in our atmosphere, and it causes a glow and it causes ionization. That ionization shows up on radar, and it's like a cat laser pointer, and we're making planes chase them.
That's exactly how they describe these things moving, like laser pointers.
Yeah, and so we can do it in three space. We can make it look like
in three dimensional space.
Yeah, and we can make it look like an entire fleet is about to drop bombs on, let's say, Europe, and then just have them disappear. And they get all their planes up in the air, and we attack them from the other direction, assuming we're attacking
Europe. Who is doing this? The Navy, you said?
Somebody. Let's just say a group. A group, you know.
And you know this for a fact.
I know for a fact, yeah. So anyway, don't tell your guests.
A group within the U.S. government.
Yeah, okay, we'll leave it at that. Yes.
Is this something that could be seen with the naked eye?
Yes, because it glows. So it would be seeable, you can see it by the naked eye, and it would leave a radar trace. So it's perfect as a deception, and it involves the voice of God weapons that I was talking about.
Project Bluebeam.
And this got leaked, so it probably won't have the effect, and they probably won't do it. But if you wanted to bring the world together, as President Reagan said in several UN speeches, you would have a common enemy, like evil aliens attacking. We forget our differences when we fight against it.
So we wouldn't look at each other as Chinese or Russian or American. We'd look at each other as Earthlings.
It's for humans. Yeah, as Earthlings. And so that was Project Bluebeam, was to trick the human race into believing either God is coming down, everybody hears the voice of God, the microwave hearing effect, get along, whatever the new message is, or it was going to be the evil aliens attacking. And notice how they, all of a sudden, all the governments release all their information on UFOs, and there's a whole division dedicated, and that's just deception.
The lots of footage and videos and photos that have not been released to the public.
Yeah, I haven't seen those, so I can't get.
And if you think this is all some sort of psyop, what do you think the ultimate purpose of it is?
Distraction against a lot of this human experimentation we're doing.
and all y'all be talking about y'all gang. This gang. This man rolled up with all his people deep. Flew in, rolled through the city. Deep. I'm talking about gang. Donald not playing. GOP. Donald like gang. Let me drop this. Ride with me real quick. Y'all, I gotta take this ride. I gotta take this flight and this ride real quick. Drop this 20 grand off to these folk since they hooping and hollering. You know what I'm saying? Look at this man riding through the city. Do you hear me? Do y'all not understand? Like, this is history. Like, this is crazy. Donald don't care nothing about what y'all talking about. Donald said, and what? You want me here? I'm in Georgia. What's up? Say something. I pulled up. I'm going to pull up on you, Fulton County. I'm going to pull up. He done pulled up on him. He said, let me pop out real quick. Yo, this man came to Georgia squat deep. I ain't even mad. I'm talking about cars for days. Like, yo, security for days. Like, yo, y'all be talking about y'all gang. Y'all don't know nothing about gang. We even got the ambulance just in case somebody get hurt. I take care of my people. Tell them, Donald. Donald said, this ain't nothing but a little pit stop. Like, this, you know what I mean? Like, this right here, y'all. God, they got this shit. It's hilarious. I mean, he riding through the trenches like, yo, what's up? And I dare somebody to do something. I dare you. Bust a move. Let me see if we can get Donald stepping out. My boy got on his blue suit, got his hair combed over, red tie because he fly. Y'all need to know, yo, y'all don't do the crime if you can't do the time and you can't pull up like Donald Trump. If you can't do this like this, talking about your people, your homeboys, your gang, your homies, you don't have none. He has them all. Like, this right here is hilarious. Oh, my God. I just want to get, let's see. They just keep talking about all this crazy stuff with him. Like, at the end of the day, let the man just turn himself in. Let's go on. Let's keep this moving, right? That's just how I see it. Like, I mean, he pulled up gang. I mean, he pulled up on him. Like, they told him, I bet you won't pull up. Donald pulled up. Like, he pulled up. Like, and I'm here. Either we're going to have a mugshot or we're not going to have a mugshot. He said either one. We're going to have a mugshot or we're not going to have a mugshot. He prepared for it all. Oh, we might not be able to see him get out. Oh, that sucks because he's underneath the thing. But you know what, though? They trying to zoom in real close. No, which one is he in, though? He's probably in the one up underneath there. Like, that's crazy. I'm here for it, Donald. Because let me say, you need to tell the people that hire folk now, I have felony charges. So if the president of the United States can have felony charges and run with felony charges, y'all should be hiring the citizens of the United States of America with felony charges because he's doing it. That's right. I'm here for it, Donald. I'm all here for it, Donald. We'll be back right at. We'll be back around with Donald again. I don't think he's going to get a mugshot, y'all, but if he do, I'm going to wear my shirt really proud. I think everybody should because he's really showing y'all, do not fear the government. You just got to go do what you got to do. You know what I'm saying? That's just how I see it. All right, y'all. We be back. Let's see if he get a mugshot or not, y'all. Okay, y'all. Thanks for checking in with your girl. All
right. Blue laser test. I got this laser on wish.com for fun. It's actually pretty powerful. I've been shining it on this blue plastic lid for about 5 minutes now. Nothing. But when I go try it on a different color, like this green, it starts to smoke. If I take another color, let's do orange, it's smoking. Let's do yellow. Smoking. Red. And I was wondering if it was maybe just the type of plastic that blue was, so I found a different type of plastic, also blue. And I had 5 minutes on this too, and nothing. No smoke, no burning. It's wild.
They're not uploading. They're not just uploading like what you saw and what you said. They're uploading your thoughts. Thoughts are just frequencies. We think our thoughts are private. Your thoughts have never been private since the day you came on this reality.
Doctor, who is it that's doing the upload? Who is it that's
Mostly the corporations in this reality. Sometimes the military, but corporations control the military. And if you want to go intergalactic, of course, I call them the Galactic Federation of Non-Light is really the ultimate puppet masters, because they're the ones that have conquered 500,000 planets in, you know, space, or in, you know, the intergalactic, you know, spaces in all the dimensions. So they're the ones that there, you know, this is a game realm. And in this game realm, anything goes, absolutely anything goes. They're allowed to take us. Everybody's taken. They're allowed to experiment on us. Now, why you're taken, who you're taken by, completely different. Like you and me and you are going to be taken by different corporations, different races, for different reasons. Sometimes we're taken and they actually upgrade our DNA, or they upgrade our body, or they fix things.
When you say taken, no, this is awesome. I love it. No, it's good. When you say taken, what do you mean taken? Like abduction taken?
So my relatives work in human cloning and consciousness transfer. So they get a paycheck from companies, the military and corporations. They cash their check, like, you know, we do, or we don't, whatever, you know?
Right.
You know, for cloning and human consciousness transfer. So sometimes your consciousness is taken and put into a cloning body. And then sometimes you are physically abducted out of your, like time has stopped and you're physically abducted out of your, you know, house, bed, whatever, wherever you are. They also, you know, the CERN, everybody's like CERN.
Yeah.
Okay, which CERN? There's like 500. Which CERN? What is CERN? CERN is, have you ever looked at CERN? Have you ever watched Stargate? Have you ever watched Star Trek? Have you watched any science fiction? What is CERN? Look at it. It's a Stargate, you guys. So all CERN is a Stargate. They've already figured out all the stuff they talk about, black holes and this and that. All this technology has existed for millions of years. They know what CERN is and they use it. Every Marriott hotel, every Hilton hotel has jump rooms in it, and the underground tram runs. Yes, I'm serious, you guys.
I'm going to tell you right now, an hour's not even close to enough time.
I want to go somewhere through a door.
No
kidding. That's all I'm saying. Hey, I want to go to Rome. Walk through that freaking door. Don't worry about it. Just go through that door. You'll be okay.
Yeah, most of our hospitals have jump rooms. You know where the most jump rooms are? Like in big cities, because a lot of cities are holographic. Ever watch Westworld? By the way, if you want to understand this reality on the highest level at 100% truth, start day one of Westworld and keep watching. Every single thing in that series is 100% truth.
I have seen every one of those episodes.
You just asked me before I
did.
Came
right
in
before
the
show, I asked him if he had seen
Westworld.
There is a TikTok channel. I'm going to throw this out there because Rocky and I talked about it. There's a TikTok channel called UHF Corp.
Okay.
It's at UHF Corp. And they remind me with their little 1 minute commercials of Westworld, but they are acting as though they are a disclosure type corporation.
The constitution she was putting forward was one that would have restored voting rights to Native Hawaiians and would have increased her powers as a constitutional monarch.
But the white businessmen and politicians were already plotting her overthrow.
Queen Liliʻuokalani became the target of what can only be described as a vicious smear campaign against her in the U.S. press. The San Francisco Examiner described her as a black pagan queen who wanted nothing short of absolute monarchy.
A trap was sprung upon me by those who stood waiting, as a wild beast watches for his prey.
Yeah, the takeover, it's a movement worldwide. They finna bring Donald Trump in, y'all see? Y'all see? Well, they deep, bro. They deep, bro. Finna bring that boy Trump. Finna bring that boy Trump. Y'all see it, man. Which one are you in, though? Oh, from Donald Trump. Talking about they got everybody. Look at that truck, though. Damn. That shit, y'all. Yeah, he gone. Y'all see him. Trump done went to jail, man. Damn.
Isn't it some real gaslighting to enslave people and then create the stereotype that they're lazy? How you come up with that? Some of the people who built the nation? That's the lazy people? And we have been so brainwashed, we believe we have to convince people it's not true by being so busy, by grinding, by hustling, by showing up for everything, signing up for everything. God said, you are already stardust.
We born not knowing. Are we born knowing all? We growing wiser? Are we just growing tall? Can you read thoughts? Can you read palms? Can you predict the future? Can you see storms coming? The earth was flat, if you went too far you would fall off. Now the earth is round, if the shape changed again everybody would have start laugh. The average man can't prove up most of the things that he chooses to speak of. And still run research and find out the root of the truth that you seek of.
White man that you see terrorizing the world today, he was in the caves of Europe, didn't know how to cook his food, didn't know how to bury his dead.
You ain't never seen a black caveman.
Why do y'all have an obsession with giving credit to other races for what black women naturally possess innately on their own? Okay, I'm so tired of people telling me this, you got Indian hair. It's coming out of my black scalp, so it's black hair. How can I have Indian hair when I am black? First of all, civilization started in East Africa, where I am from, and I'm pretty sure I was here before Indians and South Asians in general. So, I am their mother. Those are my daughters, okay? All them bitches is my son. If I go be with a South Asian man, we're gonna have black babies. If my brother goes to be a South Asian girl, they're gonna have black babies because we're the dominant gene. I cannot have Indian hair. Indian women have black women hair because they are a recessive of black women, okay? So stop telling every black woman with soft texture hair that she has Indian hair. Black people possess every texture of hair. We have every texture of hair from 1A all the way to 4C, okay? So stop it. We're every complexion, we have every color eyes, we have every color texture of hair, we have all the different phenotypes because civilization started with us again. This is black hair. It's coming out of a black scalp. Excuse me, thank you.
Excuse me. Yeah. Two of you. Yeah. I'm a reverend, I'm a doctor, I'm a prophet. When I was passing, God showed me, said I should tell you, this is a year. You're going to run into somebody very rich, you will connect into something very big. And when this blessing comes, nobody will stop it. You'll be very rich this year, two of you. Take anybody who will stop you with that.
I hope so.
Okay.
Go!